Hi everyone, it's QuickyBaby and welcome back to World of Tanks, and last week we had Dr. Babylon show you why the Škoda T56 is arguably the best tier 8 heavy tank inside the game. The same day that I released that video, on Friday, I decided to take the Renegade for a spin, and the Renegade decided to pretty much give me a little bit of a slap and say, just because I don't have an autoloader doesn't mean that I'm useless, QuickyBaby. The Renegade is only just below the win ratio, at least on the European server, of the Škoda T56, as I detailed last week. So I am actually on my desktop right now. I am auto-forwarding in this situation, and I'm going to wake up in a second and realize, oh God, where the hell am I? And I'm actually going to end up blocking the Centurion 7-1 as I manage to go in front of him. So bad start for me here. I've got to stop making a habit of being on my desktop. But again, as you are, as I am kind of trying to multitask at the beginning of the game, I really hope that the Centurion 7-1's going to let me off. But all jokes aside, the situation that I put myself in there, to all intents and purposes, I could have got hit by the Jagdpanzer 100 or some of the tier 10 medium tanks on the enemy team. Don't do that. It's a total idiot play to just slam your R key 3 times and go on your desktop and do something while you're trundling into position. Maybe you can do it in something like a T95, but not something like a Renegade, which is definitely fast enough to be able to get into position quickly. That's one of the reasons why I love this vehicle. The top speed limit of 45 kilometers an hour and the power to weight ratio of over 16 means that this tank is more like a medium with regards to its mobility. And when you have the hull armor of a tier 9 heavy tank with the mobility of a tier 8 or a tier 9 medium and very good damage per minute on this vehicle, well, I thought I said I had good hull armor there. Why is the artillery not using the stun round and deals 552 damage to me right at the start of the game? Those pesky artillery going for all or nothing hits. Just quickly, I want to highlight that I actually shoot that tree with a high explosive round to knock it down to create more of a cover here as we go up. Now, it's not going to work too much with a heavy tank like the Renegade, because obviously our camera rating is going to be poor and the bushes won't be able to keep us hidden. But if you're playing a medium tank or a light tank and you shoot the tree down in that direction, it actually means that you can go up here without getting spotted by the little campy location that your opponents will often sit in down in here. And so you can spot them out and you can even get shots into them. So definitely use that little bit of knowledge to dominate this location. Shoot the shell just before the tree, because where the splash comes from with the high explosive shell actually makes the tree fall down in the opposite direction. So fire just before the tree, use the tree's cover there, the concealment, to be able to take advantage of this scenario. So the Renegade has just got up into position, just exposes itself. That's the way that I like to play this tank. The hull armor, as I said, the T-54E1, means that you can over-angle this vehicle. The Renegade, when it first went into the game, was actually called the T-54E2, that would pretty much indicate that this thing does have T-54E1 armor. So what I love about this vehicle is the mobility combined with a decent enough penetration, even on our standard rounds there, to be able to go through the front of the Patriot, 226mm to be exact. And if you need to fire gold in a matchup like this, 255, well, it's not the best, but it's still not the worst, unlike some other tier 8 heavy tanks, which are kind of only just getting towards the about 245 mark. So we slam around once again, a regular round in through the side of the Patriot, and this thing just keeps trundling forwards because of that fabulous power to weight ratio. But one of my favorite things about this vehicle is, just like the KV-5, it has a very good damage per minute of 2,117 base. And that's because while it has 360 alpha damage, just a touch better than the T-32, right? It also has a good rate of fire of 5.88 to go with that. And so once you've got a decent crew with brothers in arms and you've got the gun handling to be able to make that good rate of fire work, maybe combine it with a premium consumable if you're a filthy pay to win player like me, or even if you're not, you can probably still break even as long as you're buying those premium consumables at half price or even very much profit out of their use, and combine it with a gun rammer and vents like I love to use on this vehicle, and it definitely feels great. I like to use vertical stabilizers on my Renegade, but I'm sure that there will be people out there, especially when you get the sixth field modification slot and you have the dual equipment, which I believe you can have on a tier 8 heavy tank as far as I can remember, putting a turbo inside the second slot with a mobility bonus from the field mods would be pretty outrageous. But I do feel like on a tank like this, that vertical stabilizers just feel absolutely awesome. The accuracy of 0.38, not too bad where you would want to consider probably using an improved accuracy module, and I think that the gun handling is really what this vehicle is all about with that rate of fire. Did you notice how we over-angle our armor on this tank? A lot like you do on an M48 A5 pattern, the side of this vehicle is actually angled. It's like a boat, which means that you probably want to advance at your opponents at about this kind of angle as we see here. And that means that they will most likely bounce off your side and not hit your weaker frontal armor, because you can bait them into shooting the side of your tank. And so that's where, for me, the Renegade is just an absolute powerhouse. Just over-angling, sometimes bouncing, and definitely whittling down your opponents very quickly. And while it may not have the alpha damage of the Škoda T56, in fact it has 100 less per shell, and it doesn't have a lovely two-round magazine, because you've got the better damage per minute, and because it's not an autoloader and so you can use a gun rammer, you can actually, in these kind of progressive fights where you're constantly firing, be way stronger than an autoloader. Of course, it's not going to be quite so good for when you need to come around the corner and finish off that tank that's going to be on about 700 or even 800 hit points in the form of the Škoda. But still, for when you've got yourself on a ridgeline, you can use the 10 degrees of gun depression this vehicle has, which is fabulous. You're going to be in a good position. So, interesting moment here. Lots of people are telling the T44 to cap, but I felt fairly confident in this scenario, along with a full health FE215B183, that we should be able to handle this situation. And so I actually gave a cheeky thank you to the T44 resetting the cap circle, even though I felt that I wasn't going to ask the T44 to reset the cap, as it was a little bit risky. So now we're just in a lovely situation of outflanking and outmaneuvering this Type 5 Heavy. We have a quick look to the right to keep an eye on the Jagdpanzer E100, and it looks like that Type 5 Heavy is using the derp gun, as we're able to put multiple rounds into their tank, now putting our damage total up to nearly 6,000 in a terrible matchup here. Well, a terrible matchup against the Tier 10s, as bad as it could be for a Tier 8 tank. But when your vehicle kind of feels as if it's at least tier 8.5, or you could even argue as close to a tier 9 vehicle as you're probably ever going to have at tier 8, doesn't really feel too bad to be playing a Renegade in a matchup like this. And I think that's what makes this vehicle just so special, and why the vehicle frankly has, I would say, it's also overpowered, and it has a win ratio that it just shouldn't really be achieving. If it was balanced, it's just shy of the Škoda T56 at 53.3 on the European server, which again means that for every player out there who's getting the average win ratio of 49%, there's somebody out there who's going to get that like 58% average win ratio on this tank. And as the special style on the vehicle indicates, dead or alive, probably more often your opponents are dead and you're the one still alive after the engagement. So yeah, no autoloader, no problem here for the Renegade, as we get 2,023 base experience points. Even if we'd got a probably about 400 or even 500 less than that, we would have still got an ace tanker in this game, as we dealt 6,170 damage to mostly higher tiered tanks. And what kind of profit do you think you achieve when you're running a personal reserve 50% credit booster? Yeah, 207,000 credits for this single game of World of Tanks, resupplying 44,000 credits of ammunition. Not too bad in that kind of a situation. So the Škoda T56, the vehicle that I featured last week, and the Renegade, both clocking in at kind of midpoint 53% win ratios. It's no wonder why Wargaming are being forced to consider putting in more tier 9 premium tanks into the game, when they've definitely pushed the balance of tier 8 premium tanks. It's an absolute travesty how far you have to scroll down to be able to find the first tech tree tank down this list, and having saturated the market at tier 8 with overpowered premium tanks, it's no wonder why Wargaming want to step it up to tier 9 now. Nevertheless, it's your hard-earned cash, and when you are wanting to spend it inside the game, you want to have the best vehicle that's going to get you the most credits and if you want to, win the most games possible. And you really can't go wrong with the M54 Renegade. Outside of that horrendous weak point that is on top of this vehicle, which I thoroughly recommend you kind of overturn the tank and go forwards and backwards along a ridge line to hopefully pressure your opponents into missing. If you can do that and you can mitigate that as a weak point, everything else statistically about this tank, including that beautiful over-angled boat-shaped hull armor to really bait your opponents into shooting it, and with new field mods making the mobility of this vehicle better than ever, and the possibility of also putting a turbo inside the bonus slot of this tank, this thing is truly living up to its name and allowing its owners to be the Renegade of the battlefield. Anyway, ladies and gents, boys and girls, that's it for today. Really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. And let me know in the comments today if there are any tier 8 premium vehicles or just any vehicle specifically that you would like to see featured in upcoming YouTube videos. It's not something that I really ask too often, but maybe I can try and squeeze some time in, rustle up some gameplay, or even possibly even play some of your favorite vehicles live. Hit me up in those comments down below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. You've been epic, and hopefully I'll see you soon.